Okay, so we've got one more email back. So let's see. Generally a good sign. That's fantastic. So that's fantastic and all correct. Nothing else to add in there. If there's anything else you need, let me know. Now, the first thing that we could do is we could just start doing the wireframes and send them over. But let's actually think about this project planning instead. So what we're going to do is actually plan out this project a little bit more. Like it might not happen. She might see the wireframes and go, actually, maybe we'll go with someone else. She might even see the budget and go, it's too expensive. But we still need to plan out this project somehow. Now, what I'm going to use is a tool called Notion. You can sign up at notion.so, and you can kind of quickly just sign up and log in if you've got an account already. I've already logged in and signed up, so I have something that looks like this. Now, generally, I don't use much in my personal workspace. I actually use a lot of things in SuPy itself. But what we're going to do is I'm going to create a brand new workspace from scratch. So in here, what I'm going to call it is something like Rick's client work. Unsurprisingly, a team size of just me, and anyone can join because obviously I'm able to let Aria join this and see this in progress. And then there's a few options in here. We could start with templates. We could start without templates. Let's have a look at the templates. So start with templates, see what there is. So in here, they've given us some templates like roadmap and user research and task list. If I click on something like roadmap, you can see here that they've got something like this, not started, in progress, complete. Now we could actually set up a page in our client work areas, something that kind of looks a little bit like this. Now, obviously you can have things like meeting notes and the design system in here, most of this stuff that we're not actually going to use, but we want to set up the templates just so you can see this in action. What I want to do is on my kind of, if I go back to my homepage, if I click here, oh, sorry, here, and I get started, what I can do here is actually create a private page and say, well, maybe I want this kind of new area all about Aria. So I'm going to create a new page called Aria Oslo Project. And then I might want to just have, there's a few things in here. I could set up with a template. I can actually add maybe some colors in here. I can actually add a lot of kind of info in here. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to type this slash like it says. And it down here, it gives us a lot of examples of the things that we can actually do here. We've got things in line, we've got a database. I'm going to create a brand new board. So I'm going to click board on database. And in here, it gives us a lot of information. I'm going to quickly open this up as a page so we can see what's going on. So in here we have no status, not started, in progress, and complete. Now with client work, generally I like to add one more thing in here, which is not started, or maybe I want to kind of rename this to something like to do. I've got something that's in progress and then completed. But I've got one more thing I want to add as a group, which is awaiting approval. Because if the client doesn't like it, it's not completed yet. So I'm going to basically move this after here. So we've got to do, in progress, awaiting approval, and completed. But what is what thing? So what I want to do eventually is kind of move these cards over piece by piece and eventually try to get them into this completed area. So what things do we want to put in here? Well, the first thing I want to put in my to-do list is wireframe. So I'm going to wireframe the site. So just going to add that in as a thing to do. Now the things that are over here are currently not ready to do. So I'm going to just have these as no status. This is kind of like a backlog. And then here we've got things like the logo design, of course. We've got the brand, which is the color scheme and typography. I want to add a new card in here, which is something like the website layout. So maybe the web layout, and also the coding of the site. So what we're going to start to do over time is we want to start moving things from the wireframe stage into in progress because we're doing things, and then we want to send it to Aria to get approval on this. So the next thing that we're going to do is actually wireframe the site, and we're going to do this on the table itself. This is a kind of simple kanban board. It's used quite a lot in project management. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to start by moving wireframe the site. And what we're going to do is actually draw this on paper. Now, the reason for wireframing the site, not really worried about the logo just yet, is we want to kind of get the basics sorted before we approve that. Once we get the approval, we can get a budget ready. Once we get the budget, we can start moving these things into to-do.